Hi children, welcome back. Okay, in this video we are going to discuss about next topic, that is about my body. Children, just you have a first chapter, okay? So already in the first standard we have learned about our body. Our body is made up of many parts, and other different parts are helpful to make perform different activities. There is a possibility of doing different activities only because of our body parts. You have learned already what are the body parts and how do they are going to help us. So in this standard you are going to learn about these body parts bit you are going to get more information about this. So our body is made up of many parts. In those many parts we have parts of a body are divided into two types. One is internal part and another one is external parts. Then internal parts, our body has got so many internal parts which we cannot see outside. And external parts, even our body has got so many parts external, those can be seen very easily. Then let us discuss one by one. What are the internal parts of the body? For example, the brain, inside our head there is a brain, heart is there in the chest part. We have the liver along with our stomach. Then lungs we have along with our heart. Stomach is there, intestine is there inside the stomach, intestine is there, pancreas are there, kidneys, bones and the muscles. These all are known as internal parts of our body because they are inside the body, they are not seen very easily. So then what are these works of these internal parts of the body? They have got most important role for our body, to maintain our body. For example, the brain acts just like a sync to our whole body. Brain is a signal, it is a just like a remote controller. It is going to control our whole body. If there is no brain, our body will not be in a normal stage. Then heart, we know that heart pumps the blood. Because of heart only we are all are alive, every human being and all animals are alive. If there is no heart, there is no life. If there is no brain, of course we can, if there is something happen to brain, we can live. But something happen to heart, we cannot live. Then liver. We know that liver is also with the stomach, which is also going to help us in maintaining, keeping the food and in the digestion, it is going to help. Then the lungs. We know that lungs will help us to breathe. That is taking air inside and giving out. Then stomach is helping in storing the food and in the digestion. There are some steps before, what are the steps should be followed in the stomach. The digestion is done very neatly in the stomach. Then whatever we eat the food, it is going and storing in the stomach. Then the intestine, here we have two types of intestines again. One is large intestine and another one is small intestine. After the digestion, the food goes through both type of intestines, where there will be a almost clear digestion of the food is being done. Then the pancreas also we have, it will help to maintain the acidic level of our body. Then kidneys we have, more important. If there is no kidney, there is no filtration of our blood. Kidneys are most important to filter our blood. Then bones and the muscles. We know that our body is, even though it is made up of blood, heart, brain, kidneys and liver, lungs, stomach, intestine, everything is there, but to hold those all the things we have the bones, that is skeleton. Bones are attached and one just like one shape is given to our body, that is only because of the bones. If there is no bones, there is no support for our body and there is no definite shape for our body. Then we can, these bones are joined together only with the help of the muscles. Again, we have very stick like bones inside our body, but it is looking very pulpy and some we have got some clear picture about my hand. That clear picture is only possible because of the muscles. Children, I hope you all have understood whatever are the internal parts of the body and how do they are going to help in the body and how do they are going to help for the different parts of the body, or what are those importance in our body we have learned. So in the next video we are going to discuss about the next external parts of the body. Those are we are going to discuss in the next video. So before ending this video, I would like to give you one small homework. That is, what are the parts of body you have to write? This is first question. Then what are the internal parts of the body you have to write? Second question. I hope you will do this homework, and let us meet in the next video. Till then, take care. Bye bye.